Kasama natin ngayon, of course, ang man behind VOLTES 5 Legacy. Na pinapanood ko lang yung mga works mo, direct, bata pa ako. Pintados, you did that,
oh my
right?
God, yes. Oh,
naabutan ko yan. Isa sa mga tinutukan ko before sa GMA. Of course, direct Mark Reyes. Maraming salamat po for granting this very quick interview.
Oh, my pleasure, my pleasure.
Kumusta po?
I'm very thankful that the response of VOLTES 5 is not only, you know, in the Philippines, but globally, you know, we're getting very good reactions from all over the world. So we're very thankful for that. It was 3 years of long, hard work to come up with something what you're seeing now on the TV screens.
Direct, of course, ang daming mga ano, diba, nung cinematic experience pa lang, ang yes. Dami ng mga comments ng iba't ibang mga netizens, and more so nung nagkaroon tayo ng TV premiere talaga. So, I wanna know, ano yung favorite comment na nabasa or narinig mo from a netizen, from a colleague, and from a family member?
Oh, among all the praises, the best praise that I got was not actually a praise. It was a father thanking us for creating a show that brought back together the family. That they finally, it's been a long time now since they all sat together to eat dinner and waited for a show together. So that's what why I do what I do, you know, to be able to bring families together and to watch a show and experience something that they could all relate to. That's the best compliment
for a director. I saw some videos noon sa TikTok, no? Pero ito, kung napag-usapan natin direct yung best comment, meron ka bang nabasa na comment na medyo nega, na medyo na bad trip ka? May ganun ba?
Meron naman, madami, no? But you know, very divisive ang project na katulad ng VOLTES 5. Even Star Wars, even Marvel has their own sense of, ano, share of bashing, of negative comments. And you know, as long as it's constructive, we will take it, ano, and kami reactive kami pag merong actually sa cinema experience may kinoment na something, I forgot what it was. Mm-hmm. Na oo nga tama yung nag-comment ito. We adjusted it for television. Basta constructive. Pag negative, we don't have time, you know, to entertain them because right. Hindi mawawala yan. Mm-hmm. We do the show for the people who likes to watch the show and who believes in what we're doing. Why would you work for someone or for people that will never like whatever you do, diba?
I think one of my favorite comments na nabasa from a famous person actually na fan talaga ng VOLTES 5, Michael V. Mm-hmm. Diba, na I saw nag-comment ka din doon direct. So ito, we have two questions lang from a netizen, from a fan ng show. First question is from Raymond Arias. Hi kay ano kay Raymond. Sabi niya, if VOLTES 5 Legacy would be successful and if GMA would be able to earn back the millions of pesos spent for the show, should we expect more live action projects for anime series with bigger budget, DAIMOS perhaps?
Yes, I think the cat's out of the bag. Miss Annette Gozon Valdez already announced that we're planning to do DAIMOS. That depends on how successful the run of VOLTES 5 is. But definitely, DAIMOS is in the, you know, is in the planning board. At syempre, no, nag-level up na tayo, nag-level up na ang GMA, nag-level up na ang Philippines. You know, so sana, ito na yung starting point na lahat ng shows na katulad ng ganito, eh ganitong level na huwag na tayo bumalik to sa yung minamadali, na hindi pinagagastusan, tapos pinipilit lang na ipalabas.
Hand to mouth.
Oo, yung hand to mouth. Sana ito na yung start ng, kasi napaprove natin na kaya ng Pinoy.
Right.
You know, kaya even the whole world is praising us.
At ako proud, Direk.
Oh, yes.
Sobrang.
Definitely.
So, ito naman next question from Kimi Olaya. Sabi niya, Direk, I know po that it is hard to act and express your real-time reaction on things you cannot see in real life. Now, how do you guide the VOLTES 5 team, especially when they are inside the cockpits while their environment is Chroma Key Studio? Kasi nung pinanood ko, I did a review, then sobrang believable nung VOLTES team, no? So, paano po?
Well, first of all, I have a bunch of talented actors. And then, that's a very good question. Kasi nga, if you see the environment they're working on, it's a green screen and gimbal with funny people wearing the Chroma suits and then shaking them left and right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for them to suspend the disbelief. And parang, okay, we shot the scenes of the kids, siguro year 2022. We shot Mary Ann sequence, the mothers,
Kaya.
2023.
Okay.
Then we shot the Camp Big Falcon sequence session sa Command Center 2021.
What? Hindi halata! But ang galing ng pagkakatahin.
Diba? Yun. So it takes, you know, well, with my guidance, proper acting and a commitment for everyone, it's gonna come out seamless.
Right.
So hirap po, ang hirap-hirap po yan para mabuo ng ganun. Kaya yun lang yun, talento ng Pilipino yan. So basically, yun kaya nabuo, natahi namin yan ng 3 years na hindi nagkikita-kita pero nag-merge at nag-vault in yung eksena, kaya ganun kaganda lumabas.
Alas na direct, please invite our kapuso abroad, lalo na dito sa Dubai United Arab Emirates na panoorin lagi ang VOLTES 5 Legacy and of course abangan ang The Missing Husband. So,
mga kapuso, nasa GMA Pinoy TV na ang VOLTES 5 Legacy. And then pretty soon ang The Missing Husband. Maraming salamat for your support. We hear you, we feel you, we are very grateful. We really try to work 100% for your satisfaction, for your entertainment. So thank you for the love that you give back to us. Maraming salamat po.
Alright, so again, sa mga gustong manood ng VOLTES 5 Legacy and iba pang contents ng GMA po, pwede nyo pong mapanood yan dito sa GMA Pinoy TV or you can subscribe sa OSN. Direct Mark, maraming salamat. It's an honor po na makasama kayo.
My pleasure.
Thank you so much po.
Tag 91.1
Pinoy talaga!